Good morning. About a year ago, I made a movie about shot placement, where to shoot, how it falls when you hit it a certain way. I had it on a DVD like this, but I decided I'd put it on YouTube in 4 segments. I hope you watch them all. My name is Eckehard, the German butcher, also known as a professional home sausage maker. And I'm also a very active whitetail hunter. 35 years ago, I started hunting with a high power rifle. Then came a shotgun and now also muzzleloader. 25 years ago, I started bow hunting. And as I got older, it came to crossbow hunting. I'm not a professional hunter, and I'm not a youth big buck hunter. Even so, over the years, I shot some nice trophies, as you see behind me. I call myself a very experienced hunter. I learned most everything from my own experiences. I analyze whatever happened to me or to our group in the world. Today I want to talk about shot placement, how it falls or how it runs away. Before I start, I want to talk a little bit about something what every hunter should know or learn. They have good eyes, good ears and a good nose. In that order, so I want to explain why. A deer can see very good, even though it doesn't see any color, it sees only black and white, but it can see any movement. In the woods, a fair distance, and in the open for a long distance. When you sit in the woods, or even outside, if you don't see them, they see you and you don't even know they're there. They have good ears, they can hear for a good distance. Even against the wind, they can hear you probably 200 yards or more. But if they're closer, let's say 50 yards or closer, they hear you and they exactly know where you're sitting and how far you're away from there. Even if you make a very little noise, they can hear how far you're away from them. And yes, a deer can smell very good, but only in the wind. If you have a strong wind, in the wind direction, they might smell you for a long way. But the other 3 sides, they cannot smell you. They can go 5 yards next to you and they don't know you're there. And when there's no wind, when it's calm, your smell lingers around you and it doesn't go very far. If they come close and they smell you, they still don't know where you're sitting or how far are you away from them. They only know they smell something. That means they go on alert. The hunter must learn to see and the reaction of the deer, if the deer is calm, and alert, or high alert. Now we come to my favorite subject. A deer will go home if it can. For example, you shoot a deer and you do not have a fatal shot. The deer will walk away. But it doesn't understand, all of a sudden it hurts. So as soon as it can, it will go and lay down. If you shoot it in the open area, it might run to the next cover and lay down. If you shoot it in the woods, it will lay down very fast. After a little while, it will try to get up and walk home. If it hurts too much, it will lay down again. That could happen 2-3 times. But then it runs away. If there is pressure or no pressure, it will walk home. If you want to see more about deer behavior in the woods, try to watch my talk about deer behavior. Now I want to come to my decoy. That's about the size of a 2.5-year-old buck. I show the shoulder bone, the heart, the lungs, the liver, and the aorta. That's a big artery underneath the spine. And I have a post standing in the center. The center does not mean the center of the animal. The center is from the front to the back. That means the center of the lungs. That's where the post is. You can imagine when you see a deer, where the rib cage is, that's where the lung starts, and it goes all the way to the front. And I imagine the line horizontal this way, inside the deer. That is my perfect aiming point. If you hunt with a gun, you can shoot from any directions. Long as you keep this point in the center in mind, you have a good shot. With a bow and arrow, you cannot shoot from the front because the shoulder bone will be in the way. Otherwise, when you shoot from the back, from here, from all directions to the back, from the top down, always have that point in mind. You have a good aiming point. The exception to that rule is the head or neck shot. So we start with the head shot. Head shot normally is not done by a hunter except if you have a real close shot and have a doe. But the conservation department and forest preserves, when they want to thin out the herd, they shoot in the head, they want to hit the brain, then the deer collapses right there. And the other deers that are there, they don't know why the deer lays down and they can do multiple shots. And now we come to the neck shot. If you aim for the neck, you should hit the bones or destroy the spinal cord. The neck gives you a very small target. I got a bone here. It looks like that inside. It's only a good 2-inch target, easy to miss. I divide the neck in 3 categories. Above the neck bone, and below the neck bone. If you shoot above the neck bone, the deer probably just runs away. You don't even know you hit it. It will survive that injury. If you have a good shot and hit the neck bone, the deer will collapse right there. On how it falls, you can see if you have a neck shot or a head shot. They fall a certain way. When you shoot and the deer pulls the front and the rear legs up and hangs in the air and falls straight down, that's a typical head or neck shot. No other shot. Head or neck shot. That's it. If you cannot see the legs, you see the deer standing, all of a sudden it disappeared. You don't know where it run to. You probably have a head or neck shot. It's important that you go down and draw blood because there's no blood loss. Now we come to the shot below the neck bone. If you hit it down here somewhere, then right or left there's a big artery going along and you have the air pipe and the esophagus inside. You hit it down here, you open up both arteries and there's no more blood going to the brain. That means there's no more oxygen going to the brain or the deer will not run very far, makes 2-3 steps and collapses. And of course this time you have a lot of blood loss. Now another situation, you aim for the neck and the deer falls completely different. Stands there, goes down by the rear end and with the front makes stiff legs and falls over real slow. What the hell is that now? You have a neck shot. That could happen with a gun or with a bow. If you hit him above the neck and barely touch the bone, just touch him. It could fall over like that. That means you have a spinal cord irritation. What the hell is a spinal cord irritation? I want to explain it to you. A spinal cord irritation is when you hit somewhere bone and not destroying the spinal cord. But from the vibration, it irritates, it passes out. And sometimes it wakes up in a little while and runs away on you. That could happen when you shoot up high. When you shoot there and it falls down like that, be prepared to shoot again. Now if you hit a deer below and it doesn't run away, make stiff legs, same thing happened. You barely touch the bone. But since you have a massive blood loss, you don't worry about a second shot. The spinal cord irritation happens most of the time when you hit the bones up here, above the spine. But it could happen also when you hit the rib. You hit a rib here from the vibration that goes through the spine, irritates the spinal cord and it falls down with front stiff legs. Whenever it falls down with stiff legs in the front like this, be prepared to shoot again, except if you already have a good fatal injury. I put my ribcage out. Now that was from last season. I had a 1.5-year-old buck, but a big buck. It's almost the size of this deer.